Pull that tape.
And up until 8:58 this morning, that was the policy. One tweet later, one policy later, a complete reversal of what many of us on the Hill were told before the confirmation, what we had continued to believe the last year, and without any notification, conversation, or dialogue with Congress. Completely reversed. Now, perhaps the Department of Justice didn't think this would be a big deal.
Okay, wow. Judge Napolitano has broken his vacation to appear on this program on the phone, and he joins us now. Judge, okay, it's okay in some states. Now the feds say it's not okay. Surely the only solution here is new legislation in Congress to sort out what's right and what's wrong at the federal level. What do you say?
I think you're precisely correct, and good morning, and a belated Happy New Year to you and to the gang, Stuart. Looking forward to being with you on Monday. Look, Congress made, for better or for worse, I happen to think for worse, but it is still a law. Congress made marijuana possession, use, transportation, or manufacture unlawful. The Obama administration looked the other way, first for medicinal marijuana, then for recreational marijuana. The act of looking the other way was reduced to writing in a memorandum by a fellow named Tom Cole, who was the deputy attorney general in the first Obama administration, and that memorandum went to all federal prosecutors in the country. Yesterday at 9 in the morning, that's Senator Gardner's reference to 8:58. Yesterday at 9 in the morning, a memorandum signed by Jeff Sessions himself went to federal prosecutors throughout the country, rescinding the Obama rule and saying all use of marijuana is against federal law and is fair game for prosecution. This is going to create a mess, not only in people's social and personal lives, but for the huge and burgeoning, you're familiar with this, cannabis industry.
So is he going to turn federal prosecutors loose in all of those states which have okayed it for recreational use and say, just go get them? Well, that would overload these officers something rotten, wouldn't it?
Yes, yes, it would. It would also infuriate the FBI as well as local police because for years, believe it or not, law enforcement has lobbied to make the personal possession of small amounts of marijuana for whatever purpose lawful because they just felt it was a waste of their time pursuing people for this. If they're going to go back to the 70s and 80s on marijuana, where people were sent to jail for 15 and 20 years because they distributed it to their friends and their friends reimbursed them for it, that is going to require an entire reorganization of the Justice Department, which is now keyed towards far more serious threats to the United States of America, yeah, like terrorism, than marijuana could ever be.
I got to say, I'd like to know what the president thinks about this. He doesn't smoke. He doesn't drink. I'd like to know. I'd like to see his input on this, because I don't think we've seen anything yet.
He hinted during the campaign that he would continue to look the other way.
Yes.
That's one of the reasons Senator Gardner was so angry, because Jeff Sessions hinted at that as well.
Okay. Judge, hurry on back from that vacation, and we'll see you Monday. Thanks for
All
joining
the best.
Us. Yes, sir. Thank you. Now, where